Welcome to Naresai Technologies. This is Ramchandar. In this video, I'm going to discuss how to develop multiple user-defined threads by using thread class. So whatever the programs and whatever the discussions we had in this multi-threading video session series, up to now I did talk about only one thread. Then how to define multiple user-defined threads. So today our discussion is how to create multiple user-defined, threads by using thread class. Yes, very simple, nothing is there. So let me develop this concept by using, let me explain this concept by using one small program. Observe, I'm taking one notepad here. Yes, as usual, I'm taking one class like mythread, empty mythread, extents of thread. If you want to execute any logic by the user-defined thread, that logic should be part of run method, either directly or indirectly. So here I'm overriding the run method, public void run method. And here I'm taking, here I'm writing one small SOP statements, system.out.println. System.out.println, what is this? Run method. Here I'm writing like a thread dot current thread dot get name. Okay. Now I'm taking one main method, public static void main. And here I'm taking string array args. Now here I'm creating an object for thread class. Yes, clearly observe. Now the actual discussion starts from here. Mythread empty one equal to new mythread. Mythread empty one equal to new mythread. It is one thread object, user defined thread object. When it will behave like a user defined thread object? Once we call start method. When this object will calling our run method? Once you calling start method. So before that, I'm giving one name to this thread. What is that? KIT. Now one more thread. One more thread object I'm creating, empty two equal to new my thread, and I'm giving one name to this thread. What is that? NIT. Now empty two dot start method, empty two dot start method. So here how many thread objects I'm creating? Two thread object, empty one and empty two. For empty one, I'm giving one name like KIT. For empty two, I'm giving one more name like NIT. Now both I'm calling. I'm calling both the threads. I'm calling start method on both the references. Then observe here, my thread dot Java, all files and save it. Let me write this one for int I equal to 1, I less than or equal to 10, I plus plus. Now here I'm writing like, I, see, first iteration, in the first time I value 1, okay. Now clearly observe, yes, I'm executing this program. Let me save this, already I saved, let me open command prompt, go to desktop, Java C, mythread dot Java. Java mythread. Now what happened here? Run method is executing by the. So let me save this one. Let me save and compile this program. Java C mythread dot Java and Java mythread. Now observe. Now observe here. Run method is executing by the KIT. And one more. NIT. Now run method executing by KIT. Again run method executing by KIT. So some period of time KIT executing. After that NIT. After that KIT, NIT. See what happened here. totally how many threads are running, how many high priority threads are here running? Totally three. One is main thread, which is going to executing main method, and one more is what, user defined thread MT1 and user defined thread MT2. Simply we can say KIT is one thread and NIT is one thread. So these two threads are going to executing run method simultaneously. If you want to, what is our title? What is our title? How to create multiple user defined threads is nothing but we need to create what here, multiple object for a particular thread class. So this is what, to create multiple threads by using, to create multiple user defined thread by using thread class. Then how can we create multiple user defined threads by using implements of runnable? Implements of runnable means very simple. Here I'm writing implements of runnable. So in this particular time we can't call start method, already we discussed it earlier. Start method is not available in the MyThread. Start method is not available in the super class like object class. And start method is not available in the runnable interface. So definitely we need to take the support of what? Thread class. Thread T1, new thread. Thread T1, new thread. What is that? MT1. And thread T2, new thread. New thread MT2. Now, so we can't apply name also in this particular time. The reason is we don't have set name methods. Now what I'm doing, I'm calling t1 dot start. Already we know the internal flow of all these statement. My intention is only one thing. Can we able to develop multiple threads by using runnable interface or not? Java C MyThread dot Java and Java MyThread. C thread 0, thread 0, thread 1, thread 0, thread 1, thread 0, thread 1, 0. So all these threads are executing what here? Simultaneously. All these threads means what? Two user defined threads. So the concept is what? How can we develop multiple user defined threads by using thread class and runnable interfaces? So this video is useful for understanding the coming classes, especially in synchronizer concept. How can we develop multiple threads? How can we lock one thread and how can we give the permission to the another thread to executing particular task? This program is very much useful for understand the concept like what you are, synchronization. So I hope you enjoy this video. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel. Thank you.